Welcome to Time Travel 32, and a look at some of my own cine film taken at British Rod Runs from 1977 to 1980. We kick off at Bisley, August Bank Holiday 1977, for the third UK Street Rod Nationals. The first Nationals have been poorly attended, the second washed out by rain, but this year saw over 560 pre-registered vehicles and lots of sunshine. Host club for the event with the Surrey Street Rodders. Steve Stringer of Star Vans and Ford dealer Quicks had a large display of custom vans, including the Jeff Ridgway painted Quicksilver, which took the Best Mural Award. That's Alan Humphrey's Daimler Hemi powered British Graffiti Pop. Dave Sharp was there with his Crusader CF, as was Simon Lane with the V6 Forston Speed Freak, complete with sexy, skinny Ansons up front. The Spirit of the 50s Club turned out in force and lined up their classic American iron. Jeff Beck blew everyone's mind when he entered three Model Bs. A graffiti coupe look-alike, a black and flamed five window with chrome wires, and his latest acquisition, the Lemon Pearl Tudor US show car called Super Prune. All three cars drew huge crowds all weekend. John Bollicino brought along his hot and bothered Rover V8 Fordson. Brian Lucas was there with his Chevy-powered Jago B Roadster, as was Rob Whitwell with his Pinto-powered Jago 5 window. This is Brian Kirby's 283-powered Prisma T, which was the old Church Brothers car from 71. Most unusual award went to Ray Christopher's Chevy-powered 1955 manual electric milk float, known as Pasteurized Express. That's Adrian Sidwell's Opus. Mike Key lined up his English Model B alongside Jeff Beck's Bees for a photo shoot. That's Derek Chapman's 39 standard Flying Ape fitted with a 3-litre Ford V6. Best British Ford Award went to Bob Rothwell's Model Y. Brian Lucas got the Best Engineered Award for his Bee Roadster. The candy-painted Jago body had been channeled over a homemade chassis. Front independent suspension was also homemade, while the rear end was all Jag. A 283 Chevy had been bored and stroked to 300 and connected to a 3-speed manual box. Wheels all round were ET 5-spokes. That's Ray Ollis's Rover V8-powered 33 Austin. And that's Tony Rose's Daimler Hemi-powered 49 Rover. Here's a close-up of Barry George's Fad T, powered by a Keith Harvey-supplied 303 Chevy, complete with Mondello heads, two Holley 600s on a YN tunnel ram. And that's Steve Smith's Moonshine Marina pickup, powered by a V6 Ford. Bob Wellstead had his 283-powered 35 Hillman Minx there. The Mid-Kent Roadsters were out in force. That's Bill Carter's 1934 Morris 10-4, called Hillbilly Express, and powered by a 390 Ford. General grabbers and flush side pipes were the hot setup for the late 70s. This Escort pickup was built by Al Llewellyn in 74 and had a 1600 hiding under the dummy blower. Body, chassis and front end on Rob Whitwell's coupe were all Jago products. The 2-litre Pinto and auto box came from a 73 Capri and rear axle from an S-type Jag, and those cowl-mounted indicators came off a Suzuki. Custom Car magazine brought along their Project Fiesta, designed by Ron Giles and built by Chris Boyle. And that's John Foster's Chevy-powered Bedford truck. Moving on now to 1979 and the Surrey Street Rodders' 5th annual Wheels Day, held for the first time at Slyfield as John Jemmett cruises in his Heartbreaker 351 Mustang, followed by Les Cousins' Disco Trucker Anglia Van and Mark Sachs' Emogination Minor Van. Here comes Dom Remnants in his Body Snatcher Sea Cab, using a raised rods body and chassis, Triumph Herald front end, Zodiac rear, 3-litre V6 motor and a couple of spades attached to the sides. Dave Curtis turned a few heads when he arrived with his Honda TN7 pickup. In the pickup bed sat a 3-litre Ford V6 with giant zoomies and an Auto Power Services prepared Wade Blower and Holly Carb. The C4 auto box connected to a reversed Jag rear end with a 5-inch toothed belt. That's Tony Hill's Tequila Sunrise Tea. Richard Fox arrives in his TR6, complete with murals, applied by Phil Bassett and Jeff Ridgway, and he won the Best Mural Trophy. And that's Roger Warren's Straight Black Victor, complete with mirror film on the windows. Tom Reynolds cleans up his Vampire V6 Escort van. Looks like a couple of Rover 2000 grills on the front. Russ Carpenter brought some noise to the event with his nitro burning blown Daimler Dinger, complete with newly fitted Piddlebilt bodywork. Best Open Award went to Martin Kelly in his Jag T Desperado. That's John Sargent's 61 Zodiac panel van, powered by a 2.5 litre Daimler Hemi. Front end was held up by a transit beam axle, while the back end was S-type Jag. That's Ken Bonner's Chevy-powered 39 Hudson. Tony Hill's T had Nailhead Buick power. Nick Butler turned up in his blown 427 Revenge. And Martin Bonner was there in his high riding 55. That's NSRA Chairman Mervyn King's Rover V8 powered pop. Bob Holland brought along his 55 Bel Air. John Pratt turned up in his chopped standard Flying Nine. Powered by a blown 2.5 litre Daimler Hemi, he had jag suspension all round. Kevin Cronin had cut off the rear half of his Pop and mated the back panel of a Fordson van to create a Pop pickup. Engine was Ford V6 with the usual Beaver front, Jag rear combination. On now to the Gillingham Custom Car Show, held in May 79. This lineup was the Eastbourne Modern Custom Club, of which I was a member, and I had my freshly flamed 64 something Rapier there. Dave Sharp turned up in his Crusader CF. He'd done the paint job himself after learning a few basics from Pete Darwell at Mix Spray. Phil Scores was there with his yellow Pop, as was Dave Finch in his 33 standard called True Brit. And this is the Wattmobile, based on a 71 Torino. It was used to advertise Watling tyres. I think this was Miss Great Britain who came along to do the prize giving. June 1979 saw the LA Roasters hold their show at Walthamstow. Mark Spooner arrives in Lemon Squash, his V6 Mark II console, which he chopped and fitted with a Mark IV Zephyr roof. That's Steve Dodd's blue and white Zodiac fitted with a 3-litre V6. LA Roadster's committee member Dave Manning ran this Cortina pickup. That's Ray Bennis's much modified TR7. Chris Matthews ran this Corvette called Easy Living, fitted with a 454 bored to 500. Thank you. Yet another V6 Mark II was Christine Mariuto's Blue Moon. August 1979 saw the Show and Go held at Detling, Kent, where a short strip allowed for a burnout competition and a bit of dragging to liven up the event. This guy got a bit out of shape on one of his rolling burnouts, hitting the hay bales. Martin Kelly was back out in Desperado. Jeff Caves was there in his V6 Sit Up and Beg Pop, as was Pete Fowler in his Soul Sensation Lotus Twin Cam Pop. That's Jeff Stalker's V6 Minor Pickup. Doug Ripley comes out in his 351-69 Mustang Mach 1, complete with wing and wheelie bars. Thank you. That's Terry Baker's Silver Temptation Anglia Band. This is Brian Bates, Yesterday's Dreams, Four Fender T, fitted with a 2.5 litre Daimler and auto box, Jag rear, 3-inch drop tube front, appliance rear wheels and Wolf Race up front. That's Steve Henderson's 383 Chrysler Pop. Milton Holman was there in his Graffiti 58. Graham Bars brings out his Boss Mustang Neon Star. Steve Henderson had grafted the complete suspension and drivetrain from a 64 Chrysler Windsor onto his Pop, necessitating the widening of all four wings by 8 inches. Mike Key arrives at Knebworth in his 327 English B sedan as we move on to the 79 Street Rod Nationals. Being on private grounds meant some rodders removing their fenders. This is Mervyn Barnett's Daimler-powered Jago B Roadster. It was later sold to Chris Boyle and then Simon Pickford, who painted it red. Paul Haig was there with his 29A Roadster, powered by a Rover V8, body and chassis were Ed Wimble items, and that's Mike Teasdale's Topolino. Stu Valance have brought along his 427 console Henry High-Rise, That's Andy Fenn's yellow Mini, which had a Morris Minor axle on the back. And that's Sandra Loveday's Pilot Engine Stretch T. Pip Biddlecombe and Reg Noyce were there. Pip's 36 Austin Ruby used a GMC-blown Daimler Hemi, while Reg's 52 Prefect used an unblown Daimler, but he'd knocked up a tunnel ram to fit a couple of Webers, and he also had a matching bathtub in tow. Roger Hamilton was there with his 3.5-inch chopped candy-painted A60 pickup. And Brian Lucas was back out in his Roadster. Watch the metal flakes sparkle as Pip Biddlecombe cruises by. Pip had built his own chassis with a Jago tube up front and S-type Jag out back. The name of the car was Rebellion. Reg Noyce's Prefect was called Southern Spookster and featured the usual Beaver Jag suspension on a boxed original chassis. Paint was silver mist pearl with candy apple green flames. That's Dave Wayne's Rover Zodiac called the Sweeney. Bob Rockwell was back out with his Y. That's Mike Burton's Cherry Pie Sea Cab, which used a modified raised rods body and 2.5-litre Ford V6. Ray Christopher's Milk Float now had a new owner and fresh paint. Jeff Caves was back out in Sit Up and Beg. That's Al Bishop's 327 Super Snipe. Thank you. That's Colin Pickett's 427 powered 56 Chevy. Not sure whose this Mark 1 was, but it was a good looking custom for 79. Derek Chapman was back out in his V6 standard. And Mick Cook was cleaning the bugs off the grill on his 671 Littlefield blown 356 Camaro. Bob Hollands and Roger Butterworth were there in their tri-Chevys. Another custom at Knebworth was Tony Freeburn's chopped Mark III Zephyr. Street Machine magazine was new in 79 and they had their Project Rover at Knebworth. Yet another cool custom was Richard King's chopped F-Type Victor with numerous body modifications. And that's Tony Theron's Rover powered 60s style T. This B Roadster was channeled over a Pilot chassis and used a Ford V6. Mike Teasdale's Topolino used a 327 Chevy and had two radiators in the back. Straight tube front axle had a rare set of McNally solid wheels while the Jag rear carried appliance slots. Mark Spooner was back out in Lemon Squash. And that's Derek Chapman's old Daimler T. Talking of old tea buckets, this is the old Jeff Beck imported Boston Straggler T from 69, now run by Terry Richards and fitted with a hot 302 Chevy, topped off with a GMC 471. John Foster was back out in his Chevy-powered Bedford truck. Another old T at Knebworth was this 350 Chevy-powered example, originally put together by Alan Butcher in 73. On now to 1980, as we visit the Smoke City Wheelers run at Broxbourne in May. Gary Wilson was there with his 3.5-inch chopped Victor, complete with gullwing doors. Engine was a 3.1 V6 Ford with auto box connected to a Jag rear. Clive Miles brought along his Buick Riviera Lowrider. Thank you. Martin Diarth turned up in his Daimler-powered Macabre Seacamp. And that's Richard Haskell's candy-painted Rover Custom. This is Barry Blackstone's chopped 3-litre Transit. Jeff and Esther Rosenberg ran this Mark III Cortina called Satisfaction, complete with red trailer interior and good old Wolfies wrapped in grabbers on all four corners. Tony Freeborn had done some more mods to his Zephyr Custom since Knebworth, including reshaped front and rear ends, white paint, padded roof, and crushed velvet interior. Dave Finch was back out in his repainted True Brit Standard. The motor was a hot 327 with a turbo 350 tranny hooked to a Jag rear, while up front was a super bad axle hung on Pete and Jake's 4-bar setup. Rob Whitwell pulls in with his improved 5-window coupe. The Pinto had long gone, and in its place a 283 Chevy and turbo 350. The body had been detailed, including modified windscreen surrounds, and Jeff Ridgway had added blue flames, and those cowl-mounted Suzuki indicators had gone. Lee Beach arrives in his glass-bodied Austin Devon. This was a rod with a history, originally put together by Peter Crane in 1971, who then sold it to Cliff Jones. The glass body was built by Fiberglass Repairs of Bromley, and Lee had taken it back there to have them chop the roof by 4.5 inches before respraying it black with green flip-flop. Engine was a 400 Pontiac Firebird lump with a turbo 400 box Pontiac rear end. Yep. out of the Victory Wheelers Rod Run held in June 1980. Bob Holland was back out in his final route, 55. And that's Brendan Fennell's 1275 Sprite Engines Minor Van. That's John Pastor's Capri Lowrider, fitted with hydraulics. Terry Baker was back out with his Silver Temptation Anglia van. And that's Mick Wood's Ford 1600 powered minor pickup. Amongst all the pops present, one standout was Ian Dawes High Riding Ensemble. The front end was held up by a tube axle on Jag coilovers, while the back end was Jag independent. Motor was 3-litre Ford V6. Brian Lucas had sold his roadster to Roy Rudge, who repainted it black. Thank you. John Bolaccino had brought along his latest creation, a 6-inch chopped HA Beaver van powered by a Rover V8. As the advert on the side of the 100E tells us, we're now at Detling for the 1980 show and go. Fred Claydon was there in his Rover V8 motivated Morris van. The chassis was homemade and fitted with Beaver front and Jag rear suspensions. And that's Phil Moles' V6 powered standard. Lee Beach was showing off his Firebird motor, and Steve Henderson was back out in his widened top. And I was there with my custom console. Once again, drag racing and burnouts drew the crowds. Stu Balance brings out Henry High Rise for some wild rides. Tony Freeborn now had hydraulics on the back of his Zephyr, and he demonstrates them to the crowd. Gary Boucher brought along his immaculate V12T, which sparkled in the sunshine. Doug Ripley was back out in his Mustang, getting a bit sideways off the line. surprise entry was Jeff Beck's Super Prune,